couple questions, if you wouldn't mind. So what I'm worried about is, after spending millions of dollars in the Millbrook District, that we let something such as that would become a nuisance to everybody. What I'm worried about specifically is a smell that sometimes is associated with these microbreweries.
We have all been excited about a brew pub, small microbreweries in the Millbrook District, going back to the planning work that we did starting back in 2006 and 7. Our concern, I think it was, you guys have kind of discussed it tonight, is permitted use versus conditional use. Conditional use allows you all and the neighbors to weigh in. These microbreweries and breweries come in all shapes and sizes. And what this conditional use process will allow us to do is to go through a process of discovery to learn potential negative impacts and give us an opportunity to work with the potential business to mitigate those issues.
I can't wait for a brew pub to be in the historic Millbrook District as part of my waking hours when I'm not at work. And that's an allowable use as we speak. And they could do that beginning tomorrow in any of the facilities that would be available in the Millbrook District. But I do believe that making it an allowable use for a microbrewery or a distillery or a winery is too much too soon. As is alluded to in the letter from Grown and Properties, our office is also working with that employer considering a location in the historic Millbrook District. A multi-million dollar project, it's far from a certainty. I will tell you, having met directly with the employer, the notion of an unconditional neighbor being a microbrewery is of concern. I wouldn't say that it's a killer, but I do think it needs to be discussed and negotiated.
John, on the other hand, never brought this up to me when he was looking at selling me his property to do this brew pub. And the only difference between brew pub and microbrewery essentially is, now if I'm a microbrewery, I can take my kegs and put it into bars. Whereas if I'm a brew pub, I can't. The process is still the same. The smells will still be the same. The exhaust will still be the same. The amount we produce will still be close to the same, if not, you know, a little less. But in that case, people have to come to our retail, get more in growlers or canning, which we can still do under brewpub. Essentially, we want to give out to Dubuque locally, whether it's Hy-Vee, all the bars on Main Street, so they can buy our kegs. If we were to grow outside of that, we would move into a different warehouse and do much larger production, where we may consider getting a large grain mill to do that augering that he was concerned about. There's no location to even do that. We'd have to go on the sidewalks. It wasn't even a concern of ours. But as I mentioned, he never brought this up previously to me. I don't know why it's a concern now.